Choosing the right migration approach is key to a seamless transition from classic to modern. Let's take a look at some of the options for migrating from your classic on-prem SharePoint environment to modern. Unlike classic SharePoint server upgrades, there's no database attach method to migration for SharePoint Online. One of the first options is a manual copy and paste. This is good for only simple scenarios and can be very time-consuming. Another option is the Office 365 Migration API. This method can handle really complex migrations, but it requires a developer skill set in Azure. Another option is third-party tools. These handle complex migrations, and they work on all SharePoint versions, but they can be quite expensive. Another option is the SharePoint Migration Tool. This is a free tool provided by Microsoft, which can handle FileShare and SharePoint 2013 migrations. Let's take a look at the supported sources for the SharePoint Migration Tool. The SharePoint Migration Tool is a great choice if you're looking to migrate from FileShares, SharePoint 2010, or SharePoint 2013. If you're migrating from anything else, this might not be the tool for you. To use the SharePoint Migration Tool, you'll need at least read access to your source and site collection admin access to your destination. There are a few things which the SharePoint Migration Tool can't migrate. Those include alerts, workflows, any third-party tools you might have, any custom code in your SharePoint, and certain list types and web parts. Microsoft has some documentation out there which lists all of the different web parts and list types that are supported and not supported with a migration tool. You'll want to check out this documentation to make sure that your list types are supported. It lists out all of the different list templates and lets you know if it's supported in the migration tool. If you're on SharePoint 2013 or have content on FileShares that you want to migrate to SharePoint Online, the SharePoint Migration Tool is a great free resource to perform your migration. Now that we're familiar with the SharePoint Migration Tool's features and use cases, let's take a look at how to download and install the tool. You can download the SharePoint Migration Tool here on the docs.microsoft site. You'll notice that there are two options to install. There's the current release and the public preview. I recommend using the public preview as you get the most up-to-date and latest features. Click on the link to install. On the next page, click Agree and select the Install button. Click Open to open the application. It's important to note that there's no Mac OS compatible version of this, so you'll need to run this on a Windows device. Click Install to finish installing the application. Once you successfully install the tool, it'll prompt you to log in to your Office 365 environment that you want to migrate to. After you log in, the migration tool will load, and you'll see a button to start your first migration. The SharePoint Migration Tool makes it easy to install and get started with your migration to modern SharePoint. Now that we have the migration tool installed, let's start our first migration. The most common migration scenario is the need to migrate an entire site. Take our Land and Hotels financial site, for example. This site has a few list and document libraries that we want to migrate. With the SharePoint Migration Tool, you can migrate all of these at once without having to do that individually. Let's walk through how to perform a migration. Launch the SharePoint Migration Tool and click Start Your First Migration. It will prompt you to enter your credentials for your Office 365 environment that you're migrating to. Make sure that the account you're logging in with is a Site Collection Administrator. Next, select where you want to migrate from. You can migrate from a FileShare, SharePoint 2013, or a CSV file. In our case, we're going to migrate from SharePoint 2013. Next, you'll need to paste in the URL of your SharePoint 2013 site. It'll prompt you to log in to your environment here. Click out of the box and select the options for what you want to migrate in the dropdown. In this case, we want to migrate all content. If your site has subsites, you can click the checkbox to migrate all subsites, and those will be migrated as well. Then, click Next. Now, we need to tell it where we want to migrate the site to. In this case, we wanted to create a new site for us for finance. When we click out of the text box, this will search to see if a site with this name already exists. If it doesn't, it will create the site for you automatically. Click Next to continue. Now, give your migration a name. Confirm your settings, and then click Next. And you'll be taken to a screen to configure settings for your migration. Here, you can define if you want to migrate over version history, as well as some other settings that you can configure. Review this screen over and click Next to continue. And click Migrate to start your migration. Once your migration is finished, you'll get a success message. Navigate to your newly migrated site and make sure that everything's migrated over properly. With some simple configurations and a few clicks, you can migrate an entire SharePoint 2013 site to SharePoint Online with the SharePoint Migration tool. Document libraries and lists are the most widely used functionality in SharePoint. Let's walk through how to migrate document libraries and lists to modern SharePoint with the SharePoint Migration tool. First, launch your SharePoint Migration tool. It'll prompt you to enter the credentials for your SharePoint Online site. Make sure that the account you're logging in with is a site collection administrator. Once the tool launches, click Start New Migration. Next, select where you want to migrate from. You can migrate from a file share, SharePoint 2013, or CSV file. Let's select SharePoint 2013. Now, paste in the URL of the SharePoint 2013 site that contains the library you want to migrate. After you paste in the URL, it's going to prompt you to enter your credentials. Once you enter your credentials, a drop-down box will be populated below where you can select what content you want to migrate. This should have a list of all of the different lists and libraries in that SharePoint site. Select the document library that you want to migrate from this list. Now click Next. Now it's going to ask you where you want to migrate this content to. Here, enter in the URL of the modern SharePoint site that you want to move this document library to. Click out of the text box, and this will search to see if that site already exists. If not, it'll create it for you. Now click Next. Now, you need to give your migration a name. Type in the name for your migration here. Click Next again, and you'll be taken to a configuration screen for settings. Here, you can toggle settings to choose to migrate versions or not, among other things. Look through the settings and configure them how you want, and click Save to continue. And click the Migrate button, and your migration will continue. Once the migration is finished, navigate to your site and confirm that your documents and libraries were migrated correctly. As you can see, it's very simple to migrate your lists and libraries using the SharePoint Migration tool.